What's up, budget billers? My name is Trail, better known as Budget Bill, and this is your fourth stimulus check update and stimulus package update for Thursday, July the 8th. Hello, great people, and it's great to be here once again. Today we have some breaking news that tells us that we are now super close to getting a fourth stimulus check. As of yesterday, the Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell said that bipartisanship is over. He said, believe the words that are coming out of my mouth. Yes, Mitch McConnell has stated that they are tired of trying to work with the Democrats and getting a bipartisan stimulus package is no longer an option. Okay, Mitchy Mitch, so what does this mean for moving forward? Well, this is very exciting news that gives the Democrats the go-ahead to press forward with passing new legislation without the support of Republicans. So let's go ahead and talk about it today. Also, we have an issue right now with our educators for our children. Teachers are protesting about schools reopening in the fall because they do not feel like it is safe to reopen this soon. And last but not least, hey, I have a super promotion for you guys that I want to share with you that you don't want to miss out on. So be sure to stay until the end of this video. Now, those are just some of the topics that we are going to cover today, but if this is your first time to the channel, hey, welcome and glad to have you. On this channel, we talk about finance, real estate, credit cards, Bitcoin and crypto, and stimulus update news. So, if you're interested in any of those, go ahead and hit the subscribe button for me. That way, you can join our community. Also, if you end up liking the content in this video, or even laughing at one of my jokes, then be sure to like this video. Other than that, guys, hey, let's go ahead and jump right into the video. Okay, guys, Mitchy Mitch is back again, and this time he is throwing his weight around about working with the Democrats on getting a bipartisan bill passed. But I think that he forgot that he is in the minority party and the Democrats are mostly in control of the House, the Senate, and the presidency. Well, I guess I should say that they almost have control of everything with the exception of the infamous Joe Manchin. But outside of Joe, the Democrats can pretty much have it their way. But Mitch McConnell came out yesterday and stated that bipartisanship is over. Believe me in the words that are coming out of my mouth. Mitch said he ain't having it. This is crucial as Mitch McConnell speaks for his party and he has made this statement at a time when both parties have already agreed to the bipartisan infrastructure deal. The reason this is so important is because President Biden has been wanting to get a bipartisan deal with the Republicans for quite some time. He has been putting progressive Democrats on hold, such as Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren, since the beginning of his presidency because he wants to give the opportunity for Senate Republicans to work with the Biden administration on getting a bipartisan deal done. But now that Mitch McConnell has stated that they will no longer work with the Democrats, this means that the Dems can go ahead and move forward with passing legislation using the budget reconciliation process, which is terrific, guys. Bernie Sanders tried to warn Biden a couple of months ago about trying too hard for bipartisanship with the Republicans. Bernie told Biden to stop trying to work with Republicans. Bernie said, voters don't really care about bipartisanship as much as people in Washington think that they do. Which I agree with Bernie. What about you guys? Do you care about having a bipartisan bill or not? Or do you just care about them getting stimulus aid to the struggling families? I mean, even before I really got interested in politics, I didn't even know anything about bipartisanship. All I knew was that Congress passed the bill and this is how it's going to affect me. So, Bernie is right. No one really cares about if this bill is bipartisan or not, although we do hope that all parties are in support of legislation except just one party doing it. But we don't sit back and wish this, right? At least not from the seats that we sit in. So, it looks like Biden is going to make the tough decision to move forward with his agenda and let the chips fall where they fall. We actually heard from the Republican Congress member of Texas, Chip Roy, and he laid out the agenda of the Republicans for the next 18 months, which is going to be full of chaos. But let me go ahead and play the clip for you so you can see for yourself.
Hey, look, you're seeing it happen right now in transportation and infrastructure, right? Pelosi is just tacking hard to the left, AOC and company. You saw it unfold with this whole Pelosi, Schumer, Biden's thing on infrastructure. We have no idea where they are. Mm-hmm. So it's going to be dependent on the Senate and what Senator Scott is able to work out with whatever coalition he can get to 60, as long as 60 is the number, which is obviously something to question. I mean, honestly, right now, for the next 18 months, our job is to do everything we can to slow all of that down to get to December 2022, and then get in here and lead.
Yep. Yep, he did say that. Now, obviously, living in the state where Chip Roy is the representative of, this doesn't shock me one bit. But in regards to getting a fourth stimulus package with additional $2,000 stimulus checks, this is some great news, especially for the Democrats. Now, if the Democrats take this message and the one from Mitch McConnell and run with it, the Democrats have the ball in their hands, and now they need to run as fast as they can, as far as possible. So go ahead and pass the infrastructure package that Biden proposed. Go ahead and pass the Americans Families Plan, which is the one most of us really care about. The Families Plan should include another one-time stimulus check, and we all hope that it will be $2,000, but Biden hasn't really spoke about the amount of stimulus that he wants to provide to Americans, but he has stated several times that the Americans need more stimulus relief aid. We actually saw last month when the April jobs report numbers came out where Biden said, it's clear that we need more stimulus. And then we saw in June where the White House press secretary, Jen Psaki, said that President Biden could be open to a fourth stimulus check. And then we saw on June the 8th that Biden was happy to hear the range of ideas on economy as well as more stimulus checks. So it's pretty clear that Biden wants at least one more stimulus check, because otherwise he would have just shot down the idea already so that people would stop bothering him about it. So what does all this news mean with the Republicans no longer wanting to work with the Democrats and their main objective is to make complete chaos for the Biden administration? What does this all mean, guys? Well, that means the Democrats, with the help of Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren, Ron Wyden, and Chuck Schumer, should move towards using the budget reconciliation in order to get things passed. The Republicans had their chance to work together. They chose to just walk away from it, and they want to make a mess in the process. So Biden needs to show them who's the boss and give the American people what they need right now. And that's not just a fourth stimulus check. It needs to also include the increase in Social Security benefits for our seniors, disabled, survivors, SSI, SSDI, and so on. Also, it needs to include the increase in the cost of living adjustment, or COLA, to 125% of the federal poverty level. As Biden said, this country is too rich and wealthy, and it's the greatest country in the world to live in. In order for our citizens to live in poverty, we must make these necessary changes for the future, and we must get the rich and the wealthy people to pay their fair share in taxes. And those that avoid paying taxes with their sneaky loopholes, we will go after them and get them to pay their fair share as well. So guys, this news could be the turning point of getting the necessary legislation passed going forward, as President Biden no longer has to worry about getting bipartisan support like he wanted. He must accept the fact that Republicans don't like Democrats and they want to do everything to cause chaos and prevent anything from passing. But tell me, guys, what do you guys think about all of this? Do you think this is how democracy should be working for the American people? Should we just get rid of both parties and create one party called the Budget Builders of America? Our slogan could be, we fight for all people regardless of your skin tone, your net worth, your fancy jobs, or whether your uncle is Mr. Trumpy. We will fight for all Americans, not just for certain ones, or whether you're blue or whether you're red. But tell me, can I count on your vote today, guys? Just kidding, guys. And now a word from our sponsors. Are you guys tired of YouTubers telling you to sign up for Webull to get 2 free stocks? Do you get frustrated after they tell you that you have to deposit $100 to receive the free stocks? Well, that is no longer the case. I have just partnered with them and they have updated their promotion specifically for my viewers. You guys, they know y'all don't have $100 to spare. We still trying to figure out how to get the fourth stimulus check. So they have lowered the bar and now you can get free stocks after you deposit just $5 or more. I know you got $5, guys. Everyone has $5 to spare, right? And the beauty is you don't have to spend the money after after you deposit it. So this is the best offer ever, where you can get 2 free stocks after you deposit just $5. Now, all you have to do is just open up an account using the link down below. Then you will receive your first stock up to $300. And then after you deposit $5 or more, then you will receive the second stock worth up to $2,000. This is totally risk-free, guys, and a great way to receive some free money. Now, this promotion ends on July the 20th. So if you're interested, the link is in the description. But in other news, teachers around the country are upset about schools ready to open back up in the fall. Teachers are protesting the reopenings as they don't feel like they are safe when it comes to returning back to school. They beg the question, how are our students going to be safe when we're not? Hundreds of teachers in Arizona, Texas, Wisconsin, and other states are demonstrating their vote in keeping schools virtual for the time being. Apparently, a 61-year-old teacher in Arizona died from the virus over the summer, as well as 2 other teachers contracted the virus during the summer school as well, even though they wore a mask and gloves the entire time. The teacher said, "The main thing is, if we can't stay safe, how are our students going to stay safe?" In Mississippi, teachers made demands to lawmakers that certain things should be met before they reopen classrooms. So, I recall in the heat of the pandemic, so many people were pushing for schools to reopen so that their children can go back to school and be with each other again. And now that the pandemic is getting way much better and schools are scheduled to reopen again, there are complaints about not sending our kids to school again. I guess in this country, you will always have some people on both sides, just like the Republicans and the Democrats. I think the bigger question here is, have all these teachers that are protesting, have they been vaccinated yet? I mean, for millions of people, that's what makes them feel safe to return back to some form of normalcy. Perhaps these teachers have refused the vaccine and they are just afraid of getting the virus. But I don't know, guys. Unfortunately, the article does not reference whether they have been vaccinated or not. So these are the only assumptions at this time. But anyways, guys, hey, that's all I have for you today. Please don't forget about the Rakuten promotion, where you can get $30 for free, has been extended through September. Rakuten is a cashback portal that offers you cashback percentages of the amount of money that you spend at your favorite stores, such as Amazon, Kohl's, Walmart, Nike, Target, and many, many more. All you have to do is just go to Rakuten.com and then click on your favorite store, such as Kohl's, and then it will redirect you to Kohl's.com's website. From there, it will track how much money you spend on your purchases. Then you get free money in return. It's super easy, guys, and I have been using this portal since 2011. So go ahead and sign up today to take advantage of this special promotion where you can get $30 for free. And if you have any questions, hey, don't hesitate to ask. And also, don't forget about the Webull promotion, where all you have to deposit is just $5 or more in order to get 2 free stocks worth up to $2,000. Anyways, guys, hey, that's all I have for you today. This has been another 4th Stimulus Check update for today. Now, if you enjoyed any of this information or found it to be useful, go ahead and hit the like button for me. It definitely helps out a lot, and it also tells YouTube to share this video with others. And if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button for me so that you can be a part of this community. And hit the notification bell to be notified of each new video. Again, as always, hey, I appreciate you guys stopping by and watching, and I hope to see you on the next video. Peace.